and moving back again when the threat had gone. They're like humans. A couple of days ago, their tree got the chop. I saw them yesterday amongst the rubble. This morning they were gone. Now, Lee, I put the Apache poem together with you in mind because it's...
Okay, so a while back, I had a few dramas with this car. It wouldn't start, the lights were dim, indicating there was a charging system. Anyway, just to summarise what happened, unfortunately I didn't check the battery. The liquid or the acid evaporated, so there's no liquid, and then probably the inner core combined and shorted out. That destroyed the generator down there, or you can also call it an alternator. That's it there, it's driven by the fan belt. At the same time there was a short circuit. I was told it's got to do with the choke. The choke's there, and you've got these three leads that runs to this solenoid here and to the choke, and there was a short circuit there, so I had a broken battery which burned out the alternator, and I had a light showing on the dashboard indicating a short circuit. So it was a real situation. So the mechanic installed a new generator and hooked it up, and then he said that there was a short circuit, so I had them take the car into town and sorted out the short circuit on the choke there. And I got the car back and there was still a light showing on the dashboard. One thing led to another, and I checked the fluid level in the battery. And I could see that there was no fluid in there at all, and so I had a new battery, and I installed a new battery, and that was all good. So anyway, then I was looking at Chevy pickup trucks, and I saw on eBay in Australia, I saw a 64 Chevy pickup truck, step side, and standard back in 64, there was a voltmeter installed, and I thought, well, what a good idea. You know, they don't have them now. 50 years later, you can imagine the dramas that having a voltmeter in all the cars would save people from breakdowns. So I thought I'd look around. I found this for about, it was quite cheap, about $30 I got it delivered. I'm going to hook it up now. So on the back you've got positive and negative, this bit here. This is for a light that lights up the instrument, and you've got these contact points here, and they join up to the battery. So you've got here, you've got positive and negative. So you've got, you hook up your positive to that one there, and that's positive, and you hook up the negative one there, and that's negative. I've got some electrical lead here that's running into the cab, and I'll just get my light, and that's running into the cab. I've brought it through there from the engine bay, and that's running along here and down and out. I'm going to install the gauge just within this area here so it doesn't get kicked around with my feet when I'm getting in and out or driving. So the voltmeter together with this thing, I got both of these on eBay. You can see there, the left hand side says alternator, the right hand side says battery, and it monitors your alternator and battery, and all of these light up. It says here too high, It's overcharging the battery, going down. Normal is in the middle, green, and yellow is too low. On the battery side, we've got charged, green, yellow says recharge, and the red says dead. This just, you know, slots into your cigarette lighter. And together, the both of them, I should be able to have a good idea of exactly what's going on with my charging system. These either light up or they don't light at all. And within that, you've also got a powerful light and a dim light within the same light. So that gives you an idea of where you're at. The alternator usually runs on normal, and sometimes it also flashes. So you've got full lit bulb, half lit bulb, and a flash to indicate the strength of the high, normal, and low. So in this car, it's a 95 Toyota Hilux. It usually sits on normal, and sometimes the too high will flash, but that's because it's a new alternator, and it should adjust a little bit maybe to normal. The battery usually sits uncharged, so I've got a healthy system. So anyway, I'll get to it now and hook this this fault meter up. Okay, so I've got my negative connected there. I've got my positive connected. The earth I don't need, so I can just easily just snip that off. And so that's connected. And I've got the gauge connected. And it's showing just on green, just within the charged area. So now I'll just hook that up to this here. I'm not going to bother wiring the light up. I'll do that later on if I need to. And the positive and negative is connected. Okay, so I've got the two gauges together, and I'll just show you how they work. Okay, so there's the voltmeter and the alternator and the voltmeter on the right hand side, and I'll just start it up now. I'll turn the key, put the ignition on first. Now I'll start it up. Right, so that's it. Job's finished. And I think this is going to be a really good decision to install this. Now I can keep track of the health of my charging system. And, you know, instead of just starting up the car one day and there's a warning light, and then later on the alternator burns out, or, you know, there's all sorts of electrical problems and breakdowns, I can see the problem happening with the alternator there above, the alternator gauge and battery, and the, you know, the charging system. The battery there, the battery gauge. For instance, as I rev the engine, if this needle was to go right up, and then as I back off the revs and it goes down to the red zone here, then I know obviously my alternator's not working and the battery's flat. So I can work out on the go whether it's the battery or the alternator. I can see any problem occurring. And yeah, I think this is a, you know, a really good decision to install these gauges. And I believe they should be in any car, new or old.